The student-produced VCU Insight program has continued to evolve. This year, we began using blogging software to create our own show's website. The change allows students to get more hands-on experience in posting their own content online, including video, slideshows, polls, and timelines. They work very hard to make sure their web stories include unique elements that did not appear in the shows that air on our Richmond PBS station. We've also created some compelling broadcast pieces, such as a story about why black students graduate at lower levels than whites.
The report from the Journal of Blacks in Higher Education suggests financial issues and college prep play a big role. Another factor is the family legacy of higher education.
So if my grandfather has a PhD, my mother has a PhD, my father has a PhD, it's natural that I get a PhD. In fact, I know how to get it. I know where to go, how to apply, what's important, how to prepare myself. You see what I'm saying? Whereas if my parents didn't finish high school, for me to get a PhD is a much bigger challenge than for someone who has a legacy of PhDs. So it's this current generation of graduates whose children will have the benefit of their parents having a college education that will give them the same footing.
We sent one reporter on a field training exercise with the ROTC to talk about the role of embedded reporters.
Gillum decided that I would join Team 1 for their third exercise on a four-part series of exercises that they do today. They're called lane exercises. We just went over a mission briefing, and so now we are in a 360 defense, which is a perimeter defense.
And our travels took us to Washington to profile VCU alum Rob Whitman, now a congressman for the 1st District. We even aired a story produced by a student who traveled to VCU's campus in Qatar.
These students are heading out to the site of a new cultural village under construction in the country of Qatar. They're also getting a chance to work on the designs for the entire project.
Seriously, I do not think many people have this opportunity, or any people have this opportunity. We're just like freshmen, and we can have something that's going to last for years and years, and we're going to get credit for it.
Credit for these students will come in the form of a grade and the potential to leave their mark in this country.
Perhaps most importantly, our students got a chance to experience what the job of a journalist entails. The thrill of entering worlds that many people never get to see for themselves, but also the sadness of covering moments of grief.
Thank you all for coming.
You're not alone, together we stand. I'll be by your side, you know I'll take your hand. When it gets cold, and it feels like the end, there's no place to go, you know I won't give in. No, I won't give in.
I would like for you all to listen to the words of Nikki Giovanni as she spoke at the memorial service at Virginia Tech 1 year ago.
We are Virginia Tech. We are sad today. And we will be sad for quite a while. We are not moving on. We are embracing our mourning. We are Virginia Tech. We are strong enough to stand tall tearlessly. We are brave enough to bend to cry and sad enough to know we must laugh again. We are Virginia Tech.
It's been 50 years since Edward R. Murrow's prophetic speech, and I'm confident these Insight students will continue to teach, illuminate, and inspire for many years to come.